Hey everyone, welcome back to another Reactions with Erin video. In this video, I will be reacting to Empty Chairs by Don McLean.
I feel a trembling tingle of a sleepless night. Creep through my fingers and the moon is bright. Beams of blue come flickering through my window pane, like gypsy moths that dance around a candle flame. And I wonder if you know that I never understood that although you said you'd go, until you did, I never thought you would.
Sorry to pause so soon. There are definitely elements that remind me of Vincent in this song. Those two are more alike than either one is to American Pie, I think. Is this kind of Don McLean's usual style? I kind of want to say, if these two songs are anything like his usual style anyway, that American Pie is kind of a little bit more rock than he usually went for, but I'm not sure. I haven't heard enough songs by him yet, so yeah, the song's beautiful. Wow.
Moonlight used to bathe the contours of your face, while chestnut hair fell all around the pillowcase, and the fragrance of your flowers rest beneath my head, a sympathy bouquet left with a love that's dead. And I wonder if you know that I never understood that although you said you'd go, until you did, I never thought you would. Never thought the words you said were true. Never thought you said just what you meant. Never knew how much I needed you. Never thought you'd leave until you went. Morning comes and morning goes with no regret, and evening brings the memories I can't forget. Empty rooms that echo as I climb the stairs, and empty clothes that drape and fall on empty chairs. And I wonder if you know that I never understood that although you said you'd go, until you did, never thought you would.
What a beautiful, heartbreaking song. Alright, so the lyrics. I feel the trembling tingle of a sleepless night creep through my fingers, and the moon is bright. Beams of blue come flickering through my window pane, like gypsy moths that dance around a candle flame. And I wonder if you know that I never understood that although you said you'd go, until you did, I never thought you would. Moonlight used to bathe the contours of your face, while chestnut hair fell around the pillowcase, and the fragrance of your flowers rest beneath my head, a sympathy bouquet left with a love that's dead. So, I figured, you know, by the title and the first verse that, you know, empty chairs, it's about a significant other who has gone away. And first I was thinking maybe like divorce or something like that. But then that line, a sympathy bouquet, I was like, it hit me. I was like, she's dead, you know? He's singing about her. She's dead. And I wonder if you know that I never understood that although you said you'd go until you did, I never thought you would. Never thought the words you said were true. Never thought you said just what you meant. Never knew how much I needed you. Never thought you'd leave until you went. That's kind of an interesting line there. So I've said before on this channel, I'm a nurse and I take care of people with Alzheimer's. And that line, never thought you'd leave until you went, reminds me of Alzheimer's, you know. It's so sad to watch because the person loses their memory slowly. And towards the end, it's almost like they're just a shell of a human, you know. I mean, not literally, but that's what it seems. Hopefully this doesn't sound awful. Hopefully you guys get what I mean, but it's like they're just a shell of a human, you know. Their personality is gone, their memories are gone. Yeah. Morning comes and morning goes with no regret, and evening brings the memories I can't forget. Empty rooms that echo as I climb the stairs, and empty clothes that drape and fall on empty chairs. And I wonder if you know that I never understood that although you said you'd go until you did, I never thought you would. Wow. So beautiful, so sad at the same time. I'm sorry, it's after 11. Yeah, I've been up since 7 this morning, so a little bit tired. Don McLean went through some rough times, which are reflected on his American Pie album. His father died when he was just 15, and his marriage was on the rocks when he recorded the album. Faced with a bout of depression, he sympathized with Vincent van Gogh, the Dutch painter who went insane and cut off his ear. Speaking with the UK newspaper, The Telegraph, he revealed that this song was about a man who loses a love. The empty chairs are Van Gogh's paintings of a chair. Oh, really? So, he must have done Vincent before he did this song. To, you know, tie the two together. That's really cool. Lori Lieberman, who sang the original version of the hit Killing Me Softly with his song, claims that Empty Chairs inspired that song. A press release tells the story. Don played a show at LA's Troubadour Club. Singing Empty Chairs inspired Lori Lieberman to write the song Killing Me Softly on a napkin. I was actually blasé about going. I'm not familiar with that word. Blase with a little mark over the top of the E. Not familiar with that word. I didn't know who he was, but from the moment he walked on stage, I was spellbound. I felt as if he knew me and his songs were about my life. I felt like he sang into my soul. Originally called Killing Me Softly with His Blues, Lori's poem inspired songwriters Norman Gimbel and Charles Fox to write the song for her. It was released on her debut album in 1971. There's another side of the story, which Charles Fox told us. It really didn't happen that way. Norman Gimbel and I wrote the song for a young artist whose name was Lori Lieberman. Norman had a book that he would put the titles of songs, song ideas, and lyrics or something that struck him at different times. And he pulled out the book and he was looking through it. He said, "Hey, what about a song titled Killing Me Softly with His Blues?" Well, the Killing Me Softly part sounded very interesting. With His Blues sounded old-fashioned in 1972 when he wrote it. So he thought for a while and he said, "What about Killing Me Softly with His Song?" That had a unique twist to it. So we discussed what it would be, and obviously it's about a song, listening to the song and being moved by the words. It's like the words are speaking to what the person's life is. Anyway, Norman went home and wrote an extraordinary lyric and called me later in the afternoon. I jotted it down over the phone. I sat down and the music just flowed right along with the words, and we got together the next morning and made a couple adjustments, and we played it for Lori, and she loved it. She said it reminded her of being at a Don McLean concert. So in her act, when she would appear, she would say that, and somehow the words got changed around, so we wrote it based on Don McLean. And even Don McLean, I think, has it on his website. But he doesn't know. You know, he only knows what the legend is. The title appears only once in the song, showing up in the last verse in the line, "and empty clothes that drape and fall on empty chairs." According to McLean, his record company wanted him to change the title to "I Never Thought You Would." Since that's a prominent line in the chorus, McLean refused. "To me, that wasn't what the song was about," he said. So that is Empty Chairs by Don McLean. Thank you so much for requesting this song. It's beautiful. Thank you. Hope you guys have a great day. Aaron out. Talk to you soon. Bye.